The phosphorus sun. There are a few more iconic chemistry demonstrations. In fact, if you were to think of a painting of a chemist at work, you'd probably be thinking of a Joseph Wright image, or at least one heavily influenced by him. Paintings with such catchy titles as The Alchemist, in search of the Philosopher's Stone, discovers phosphorus, and prays for the successful conclusion of his operations, as was the custom of the ancient chemical astrologers. The subject is often depicted basking in the warm glow of science, and there's a palpable sense of awe. It's a shame then that as white phosphorus has become increasingly difficult to get hold of, I get the sense that fewer people are demonstrating this reaction in schools, partly because many seem to think that it can't be done with red phosphorus. It can. Obviously, you're going to need some phosphorus. About 0.4 grams is more than enough to fill a deflagrating spoon. Make sure it's a clean one. A 1 decimeter cubed round-bottomed borosilicate flask is going to provide us with the sun for our reaction. I'm using a 10 decimeter cubed flask here. The larger flasks have the advantage of this smoke effect at the beginning lasting a lot longer and being more dramatic. So if you do have a larger flask, go ahead and use it. You're going to be looking ideally for a thick-walled flask, and you can actually get a fairly decent price on these flasks on eBay at the moment if you look around. It's worthwhile investing because there's so many demonstrations that just work so much better if you have a nice size round bottom flask to work with. The flask is going to need to be completely full of oxygen for this to work with red phosphorus. And you can do this by downward displacement of water from a gas cylinder or oxygen generator. Or you can flush the flask with oxygen gas in a fume cupboard for 5 minutes. I've bored a bung so that I can run my deflagrating spoon through and a delivery tube. Okay, and that's going to be connected to some water and trapping any expelled gases. The water has some indicator so that if any gas does bubble out, we can see the effect it has on the pH. Once you're ready, heat the end of a glass stirring rod in a roaring flame for about 30 seconds and touch the end against the phosphorus. This time, very little gas was expelled, so we'll use this solution in a moment. It's a good idea to remove the end of the tube as the reaction subsides to avoid suckback. Once the reaction is complete, ensure that the round bottom flask is cool before adding the water and indicator solution. This is going to help to dissolve the phosphorus pentoxide mist that we've produced. If it's not already done so, because sometimes insufficient heat is generated in the larger round bottom flasks to generate many bubbles, then now it will change red as phosphoric acid is formed. The structures of the allotropes of phosphorus presents a number of unusual properties, making it an ideal candidate for discussion with older students. Before I get on to the reactions of the period 3 element, I'll already have covered structure and bonding, so I'll invite my students to draw the Lewis structure for phosphorus and use this to predict some of its properties before I actually get it out and show them. Inevitably, they end up drawing a diatomic structure analogous with that of nitrogen. And an opportunity presents itself here to have a look at how the atomic radius affects the strength of the pi bond and the implications for the structure of phosphorus and sulfur, for example, when compared with nitrogen and oxygen, which of course are diatomic. We also have the comparison between silicon dioxide and the dramatically different carbon dioxide. So I've collected together some bond enthalpy values which might be of use to you, and I've placed them in this month's article in Education in Chemistry, a link to which should appear somewhere around down here. And I invite you to go and have a look at those with your students. And in the meantime, keep that phosphorus sun glowing. Don't let it die out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.